If you have a computer, odds are it's going to have PCI Express in it. And the latest version is Gen 6. So could you tell us a little bit about what's the difference between 5 and 6 these days?
Yeah, that's a good question, Bill. There's a pretty fundamental change, actually, between PCI Express 5.0 and PCI Express 6.0. Mm-hmm. Of course, we doubled the speed. That's what everybody expects. New versions of the spec want faster all the time.
Right.
But we actually have changed the protocol this time around. We moved to something we call FLITs, or flow control units. Mm-hmm. And we did that in order to simplify the error correction mechanism. So when we sped up PCI Express, we went from what we called NRZ signaling to something called PAM4 signaling.
Okay.
And sort of the layman's explanation of that is the signals get a lot smaller, so noise becomes a much bigger factor. In order to keep things from being crazy expensive to build, what we did is we changed the way we send the actual ones and zeros of data across. We put them into these little chunks called FLITs, and then we use something called forward error correction, or FEC, to fix up the bits. So if you and I are communicating and I send you a chunk of PCI Express data, the first thing you're going to do with it now is apply that FEC and fix potentially some of the errors. That means that the electrical signaling can be cheaper, can be easier to implement. So that's kind of rippled throughout all of PCI Express and made all these PCI Express 6.0 devices now have this new mode of operation. But don't worry, I know you were going to, the next thing you were going to say was, is it going to work with my old ones? And absolutely, we've kept that backwards compatibility. So you can always take a PCI Express 6.0 device. You can find one of those PCI Express 1.0 systems from way back when. It's probably one in your basement and mine.
Definitely.
But you should be able to plug that card in and it'll just work.
Now, doesn't that make the actual controller a bit more complex? Because how many different real protocols are underlying that?
It does, it does. It's kind of one of the dark secrets, if you will, of PCI Express. So for the old original 2.5 gig and 5 gig speeds, mm-hmm. we used an 8B10B encoding. Then when we went to the next generation of speed, which was 8 gig, and I had to go explain to a whole lot of people over a lot of years how 2 times 5 was suddenly equal to 8. But we made that work by changing the encoding.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a second set of encoding that works at 8 gig, 16 gig, and 32 gig. Now with this flip mode, there's kind of a third one. So yeah, we're making the controllers, the digital logic that implements PCI Express, we are making that more complicated.
Okay. Now, the functionality is also potentially changing. There are additional features and things like that. What are some of the new ones?
There are, and one of the kind of underappreciated, I think, but most exciting features that came out in 6.0 is something we call L0P. Not a really cool name. I know. We got to come up with better names somehow, I guess. It's actually a way to change the width of a PCI Express bus without stopping the data transfers. So we've always been able to negotiate different widths. You can have a what we call by-16, or 16 lanes of PCI Express. And you and I would agree between us what our common link width was. If we wanted to change that, we had to kind of stop transferring data and then change the width and then start transferring data again. What L0P lets you do is keep transferring data while we add some additional bandwidth. And likewise, when we decrease our bandwidth, we can keep moving data on the lanes that are going to stay alive.
That sounds like an interesting advantage, because from a power standpoint, if you're going to be using fewer lanes, it's going to be more power effective.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. And depending on the type of application that you have, you might be making these changes fairly frequently, right? Mm-hmm. You might go to that wider width, move some data, and then kind of shuttle things down while it's quiet outside or whatever. So, yeah, we think it's actually going to be pretty popular with a lot of new devices, but it's a bit subtle. It's not necessarily you're going to be looking at like, oh, does my new car have L0P in it? But
now, starting with Gen 5, there are some other protocols that were actually built on top of PCI Express, CXL, and is it supported in Gen 6?
Yeah, so PCI Express added that alternate protocol negotiation feature, and we intend to keep that throughout. There are other standards bodies building on top of that, and yeah, so we should keep enabling that. PCI Express 6.0, PCI Express 7.0 on the horizon, We have no plans to get rid of that feature.
Okay. Well, again, looking forward, what are we going to be seeing in Gen 7? Between 4 and 5 and then 5 and 6, there were some major changes. You know, we're talking about going to PAM 4, for example. Are we going to see the same kind of thing going from 6 to 7?
Yeah, so 4 to 5 wasn't too bad. 4 to 5 was mostly a speed bump.
Mm-hmm.
5 to 6 was big. The plan is for 7 to be much more like the 4 to 5, 3 to 4. We're trying to really just keep it to the speed change.
Mm-hmm.
Staying with PAM 4 signaling, using the flip mode, all the things that we developed for 6.0. So, you know, knock on wood, the hope is that 7.0 will continue to be a very incremental change and a much simpler transition for folks.
Well, excellent. Well, thanks for filling us in on what's going on in the PCI Express space.
Always good talking to you, Bill.